at verse number 19. Hebrews chapter 10, and the verse is 19. Reading from the English Standard Version of the Bible, there you will find these words. Therefore, brothers, since we have confidence to enter the holy places by the blood of Jesus. I want to talk about nothing but the blood of Jesus on tonight. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Now, we're going to make this lesson very simple on tonight, and we're going to begin with a thesis so that you know exactly where I'm going before I get there. What can wash away my sins, as the old hymn says? The answer comes back, nothing but the blood of Jesus. So we maintain that the blood of Jesus is what washes away our sins. We also understand that the Bible teaches that baptism does the same thing that the blood of Jesus does. You have many people today that will say, oh, I've been washed in the blood of the Lamb. I've been washed by the blood of Jesus, and yet they have never been baptized. Or many will say that they made contact with the blood of Jesus in the absence of baptism. Well, I want to make it abundantly clear on tonight that that is a biblical impossibility, because we can only meet the blood of Jesus in the waters of baptism. So dealing with these facts, therefore, baptism is essential to salvation, for we meet the blood of Jesus in the waters of baptism. Now, there are two verses that we're going to pretty much center our text on tonight, and that is Romans chapter 6, verse 3, as well as John chapter 19, verse 34. But before we read those verses, there's a chart that I want us to see to prove that what the blood of Christ does biblically is also what baptism does biblically. We see that there is an action, that there is the blood, and there is baptism. The first action that I want to talk about on tonight is forgiveness. The blood of Jesus forgives us of our sins, but also baptism is used to forgive us of our sins. When we take a look at Matthew chapter 26, verse 28, when Jesus instituted the Lord's Supper, in Matthew chapter 26, verse 28, Jesus said to his disciples, "This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for many for the remission of sins," or for the forgiveness of sins. The same language is used to talk about baptism when we take a look at Acts chapter 2, and the verse is 38. Beginning in verse 37, they said, "Men and brethren, what shall we do?" The apostle Peter stood up among them and said, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus for the remission or the forgiveness of sins." So we see that the blood of Jesus forgives us of our sins. Baptism also forgives us of our sins. As we go a step further, we see another action, and that action is washes or wash. When we take a look at Revelation chapter 1, verse 5, the Bible teaches us that the blood of Christ washes away our sin. Now, when we look at newer translations, we may not see that word wash. We may see that word freed. In other words, the blood of Jesus free us from our sins. But in the older translations, you will see, like the New King James and the King James, that that word is washed by the blood of Jesus. But if we're actually looking for another verse in the newer translations that speak to our sins being washed away by the blood of Jesus, that would be Revelation chapter 7, and the verse is 14. So we are washed by the blood of Jesus. Our sins are washed away by the blood of Jesus, but also baptism does the same thing. When we look at the words that the preacher Ananias said to the Pharisee Saul that day, when Saul begins to recap his conversion, who we know today as the Apostle Paul, when he recounts his conversion, he says what Ananias said to him. He says, "What are you waiting for? Oh, why tarriest thou? Arise, be baptized, washing away your sins, calling on the name of the Lord. So we see in the book of Revelation that the blood of Jesus washes away our sin. We also see that baptism does the same thing, washes away our sins. But not only does the blood of Jesus and baptism forgive us of our sins and washes away our sins, but the Bible teaches us that the blood of Jesus and baptism also cleanses us. When we take a look at 1 John chapter 1 and the verses 7, the Bible there teaches us that we have been made clean by the blood of Jesus, or the blood of Christ. And then also a scripture that we look at when we talk about marriage in Ephesians chapter 5. We see that in Ephesians chapter 5, verse 26, right in the middle there, it talks about how we have been washed by the waters, by his pure word. And so we see that baptism also washes away our sins, cleanses us, just like the blood of Christ cleanses us. And not only that, most importantly, we see that we are saved by the blood of Jesus, just like we are saved in the waters of baptism. When we look at Romans chapter 5 and the verse is 9, the Bible tells us that we have been made, we are justified by the blood of Jesus, by which we are saved. So we must make contact with the blood of Jesus in order to be saved. And then when we fast forward to 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 21, the same language is used to suggest that we are saved by baptism. The Bible tells us in 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 21, and the like figure doth baptism also now save us. Not the putting away of the filth of the flesh, but an answer of a good conscience towards God by the resurrection of Jesus Christ. And so I want us to keep these things in mind as we look at two passages of scripture. The first one is found in Romans chapter 3 and the verse, Romans chapter 6 and the verse is 3. Because in Romans chapter 6 and the verses 3, we see that we're not looking at blood in one text and baptism in another. We see it put together when it talks about what we must do in order to be saved. In Romans chapter 6 and the verse is 3, the Bible reads, "Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death?" So what is the Bible telling us here? When we understand what it means to be baptized into the death of Jesus, we look no further than the crucifixion. Jesus bled on that cross. Jesus died on that cross. Sin was nailed to that cross. The penalty was paid on that cross. So when we are baptized in water, we cannot avoid the blood of Christ. We cannot avoid the death of Christ because we are actually baptized into his death. Baptized into Christ's death is making contact with his blood, and not a moment before. We do not meet the blood of Christ before baptism. We do not meet the blood of Christ later on. It's in the very act of being baptized in water that we meet the blood of Jesus. Not convinced with Romans chapter 6, verse 3, maybe we need to go back to the crucifixion and take a look at John chapter 9, verse 34, in which we cannot separate the two. In John chapter 19, and the verse is 34, the Bible reads, "But one of the soldiers pierced his side with a spear, and at once there came out blood and water." One of the things that we must understand is that in that crucifixion account, we understand that Jesus bled, but when he was pierced in the side, not just blood came out, it was blood and water. Now here's the significance of that. We are baptized into the body of Christ. The Bible tells us that in 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 13. So in order for us to enter into the body of Christ, the Bible says we are baptized into his body. So that means that when we make contact with the water to enter into the body of Christ, we cannot separate it from the blood of Christ, because when that opening was literally created, it was also spiritually created to make it clear that when we make contact with the water, we also make contact with his blood. So if we make contact with blood, we're going to get wet. And if we get wet, we're going to get bloody. Why? Because when Jesus died and he was pierced in the side, water and blood came out. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 13 says that we are baptized into his body. Therefore, it is only when we make contact with the waters of baptism that we make contact with the blood of Jesus. So answering the question again, what can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. And we cannot make contact with the blood of Jesus in the absence of being baptized in water, so that we may have our sins forgiven, so that we may be washed, so that we may be cleansed, and so that we may be saved. So where do you stand on tonight? Have you been washed in the blood of the Lamb? If you have not been baptized into Christ, then you have not been washed in the blood of the Lamb. And you need to make contact with that blood on tonight. As we have just studied from God's book, the Bible, that in the absence of his blood, you are still in your sins. You are still stained with sin. You need to be cleansed from the blemishes that have been created because of sin. And you are not in Christ, you are out of Christ. And therefore, you need to be baptized into Christ. Make contact with his blood on today. And you must do it by his authority. The way you do it by his authority is that you need to hear who he is, what he has done. We just read where Jesus died on the cross for our sins. He didn't sin. We sinned. He didn't fall short of God's glory. We fell short of God's glory. Do we believe that he died for me? Do we believe that he died for you? Do we believe that he died for us? If so, give up the very things and practices that sent him to the cross in the first place. And that's our sins. Confess him tonight to be the Son of the living God and be baptized, making contact with the blood of Christ, so that you can be washed and cleansed, forgiven, and saved. If you are a Christian on tonight, you've already been baptized into Christ. You've already made contact with his blood. Have you been telling the story? Have you been sharing the good news from the graveyard? Have you been talking to people about that old Jerusalem gospel? Are you making God's already easy and simplistic plan elementary to those that you come in contact with, so that not even a blind man can miss what the text says? Are we making it plain? Are we sharing it? Are we enthusiastic about what it is that we are a part of and what Jesus has done for us by redeeming us by his blood? If not, this is our opportunity to renew our faith, to renew our covenant with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the one who bled for us, so that we can be set free by that very blood that can save an entire world. Wherever you are on tonight, we ask that you make a wise-hearted decision while together we stand and sing the song that has been selected.